We're back.
Und das war Psych Soundtrack for the Underground Nation, der nie gedreht wurde, aber vielleicht ja noch gedreht wird. Und das ist jetzt Steve Hillage, Rainbow Dome Music. Und das, weil Derek May an einem sehr unwahrscheinlichen Projekt eigentlich mitgemacht hat, nämlich System 7 mit Steve Hillage, mit Youth, mit Alex Patterson from the Orb. Mm-hmm. How did that come about? It's very unusual.
Yes, it was a strange coincidence. Steve Hillage heard one of my songs in a club, and I had never met him before, and he contacted my manager, we met, and he was very different. You know? So we agreed to work on some music together. And it was very different for me because, see, I normally don't work with anyone. Carl was about the only person I ever worked with on some music. And that was also difficult for him as well as me. But we sat down and we tried to make music. And it took maybe it took a day to realize that we couldn't work like two people working in one room together. So I told Steve, I said, go home and come back tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
And then what I have for you, you take it from there.
Mm-hmm.
So I did this, I did Altitude. And so he came in and he played his beautiful, beautiful guitar. And the way he plays guitar, he uses little metal instruments to rub up against the strings and all kinds of things. He made this beautiful song, you know. So I was really happy with it. And that's how I met him, basically. So now we're working on a new System 7 project.
Uh-huh.
And basically, System 7 is going to continue to be a group. It's going to be a variety of people, but the nucleus will be Alex Patterson and myself, and then of course Steve Hillage to front the project and to head it, to be the figurehead and control. So Steve wants to keep this going. I'm happy because I really think that it's a privilege to work with a man like that.
Also Steve Hillage hat einen Derek May Track gehört und hat ihn halt gemacht, wie das halt immer so geht, und sie haben sich halt getroffen und sie konnten zwar nicht miteinander arbeiten, aber sie haben das alles getrennt gemacht. Aber Derek bewundert sehr, wie er seine Gitarre bearbeitet, mit kleinen Metallstücken auf den Seiten rumstreicht und alles sowas.
Privilege.
What's your favorite music to dance to?
When you are on the dance floor yourself? To dance to?
Well, at the moment.
You know, a lot of people say, Derek doesn't dance. I say, I've never seen him dance in my life. Wrong. I love to dance. It's just unfortunate that there's no DJs out there that can make me work my box. Okay? And usually, there was only one DJ that made me dance, and he just died. He probably was the greatest DJ in the world. There's no DJ. There's nobody that even can come close. Not Frankie Knuckles, Larry Levan. No one. His name was Ronnie Hardy. And he was from Chicago, and he was more or less the originator of the plus 8 pitch volume, doing the things that I do, and the whole concept of playing with reel-to-reels and playing acetates and cassette mixes. Mm-hmm. And he was the man. He invented that whole concept. And recently he just died about 2 weeks ago. But he was the only person that could make me dance. I'm looking for somebody that can make me dance.
Mm-hmm.
So when I travel, I always look to dance. But, well, you know.
What was it, his name?
Ronnie Hardy.
Ronnie Hardy.
Unfortunately, he was never known because Ronnie was, he was sort of trapped in Chicago. He was a part of the original house movement and he never left Chicago. So Marshall Jefferson, Larry Heard, Steve Hurley, Chip E., the list goes on of all the people that he influenced and touched and did something for musically, you know. But, Robert Owens, Larry Heard, and Marshall Jefferson and myself are working on tribute for him.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, we really want to do it. I mean, you know, it's I really, really, this is a project I really want to do, and I hope that it comes off.
Der einzige DJ, zu dem Derek May tanzen kann und der ihn wirklich zum Tanzen gebracht hat, erzählt er gerade, ist jemand, der unbekannt ist, und zwar Ron Hardy aus Chicago. Er ist leider vor 2 Wochen gestorben. Und die gute Nachricht dabei ist, dass Marshall Jefferson und Derek May. And who else did you say? Sorry.
That's all right, baby. it's Marshall Jefferson, Ronnie Hardy. No, I'm sorry. Ronnie Hardy can't.
For him.
Ronnie, yes, for Ronnie. But it's Marshall, Larry Heard, Robert Owens, and myself. And anybody who never had a chance, of course, no one in Germany basically had a chance to hear this man. But if you ever heard him, it would have changed your life. You know, I've had people come up to me and say, Derek, you know, your music has changed my life. That's a very, very wonderful thing to say, for somebody to say to you, you know. But I can seriously say that Ronnie Hardy changed my life completely.
Wow.
You know, I mean, when I walked in when I was like 20 years old, 21, 22 years old, and I went to hear him play, it just changed my whole life. And there's a few people that are involved with this, with the original electronic techno music from Detroit, and they heard him play as well, and it changed their lives as well. You know, so hopefully this record, this tribute, will pay a little respect to him, and people will say, well, who was Ronnie Hardy? You know, and well, at least they will know at least who he was. You know,
great. Also, die bringen ein Tribut raus, damit wenigstens im Nachhinein so ein bisschen von der Anerkennung kriegt, die verdient. Und muss fantastisch gewesen sein, weil nicht nur Derek sagt das, sondern auch andere Leute aus Chicago, die im T-Word-Movement dabei waren.
The T-Word.
Für die hat er absolut ihr Leben verändert. Und er war der Erfinder des Plus-8-Pitchens. Do you sometimes wish that there was plus 16?
No. Hell no. God no. I really, you know, actually, I don't play everything in plus 8. I mean, that's a myth. I play music according to how I feel and according to how it feels, to how, what the vibe is on the floor, on the dance floor. Everything is a vibe. I mean, you can have the hottest records in the world, but if there's no vibe, there's no vibe. People don't have to dance just because it's good music. It's the way it's played. It's who's playing it. And, you know, no, I would never want a plus 16. Actually, you know, plus 8 is plenty.
What's your mood today?
My mood today is bigger than eggs. No, my mood today is, I don't know. I won't know until I walk in.
Okay, yeah, you know? I understand that.
But I know that I have a program that most people probably won't understand, because I'm not playing rave, but at the same time I play electronic music. So there's like a contradiction to a lot of people there. They don't really understand what's the difference. Well, tonight we're going to give you the difference.
Okay.
We're going to explain the definition of electronic music, and we're going to explain the definition of what techno was, and we're going to explain the definition of what we would like the future to look like, maybe just a little bit. That's all we can do.
Also, ihr habt's gehört, heute Abend, das waren die magischen Worte, heute Abend wird's geschehen. Derek wird euch zeigen, was elektronische Musik ist, aber trotzdem nicht rave. Und wie es in der Zukunft ausschauen wird und wie es war und alles auf einmal. Und er sagt, es kommt auf die Stimmung an, in der man ist. Und ich denke, er ist in ziemlich guter Stimmung. What's your favorite track of all your tracks?
Ah, you mean of my own, my own releases?
Inevitable question.
I would say probably, That's a good question. Why did you give me a question like that? Let me think. The clock is ticking. The clock is ticking. Ticking, ticking. The clock is ticking.
Some ambient music playing, you know. Nah, take your time.
I'm thinking. Well, actually, my favorite track is not released. And it probably never will be released, unfortunately.
Good answer.
So it's actually called Hand Over Hand. And it's my favorite. But my most favorite release track is probably Beyond the Dance.
Uh-huh.
The cult mix of Beyond the Dance. I've always loved that track. I always thought, to me, that was a breaking point for me musically, you know, because I was starting to develop technique. I wasn't just, you know, just trying things and they worked, but I was actually developing a sound, you know. And that's why I enjoy that so much, because that was my stepping stone.
Yeah. What is Beyond the Dance?
Beyond the Dance is beyond the dance. You can't dance unless you go beyond the dance. That was the song MS-11 on Transmat.
No, but I mean, what is there beyond the dance?
Usually, beyond the beyond is beyond the dance. That's where the dance beyond begins.
And that's how we started.
Beyond the beyond. Because the end of the beginning is the beginning of the end.
That's right. And that's life, basically.
Because life is life and rhythm is rhythm.
Und so sind wir jetzt am Ende. Und so haben wir angefangen. Sein Lieblingstrack ist Beyond the Dance. Den habe ich leider nicht aufliegen, sondern Strings of Life. Aber das passt auch. Strings of Life, because life is life.
And rhythm is rhythm.
And I thank you very much for being on the show.
No, thank you for having me on the show.
Berlin.
Berlin, thank you very much for having me tonight.
Und heute Abend im Tresor, are you playing upstairs or downstairs?
I'm playing all over the goddamn
place.
I'm playing upstairs. I'm going to have fun. Mm. And then, you know, please come out with an open mind tonight. You know, just have fun. I mean, too many times we get hung up, you know, into stereotypes as far as music is concerned. Now that techno is the big thing. I mean, I should be the one preaching techno, but I preach music, you know. I wish the DJs, because see, the DJs are in control. I wish they would listen to that and just not stop playing music, regardless of where it comes from or what it is. If it's good, play it.
Okay, we will.
I will. You will, of course you will.
Was immer gut ist, es soll gespielt werden. Und was zählt, ist nicht irgendein Stil oder sowas. Aber ich denke mal, die Message ist inzwischen rübergekommen. Okay, I hope you're having a good time yourself tonight.
Definitely.
And I'll see you then. Thanks again. And have fun.
Bye.
Bye. Heute dieser Tag. Aber ich hoffe auf vergnügliche Art und Weise. Wie ihr bestimmt gemerkt habt, der Bericht über New York entfällt heute, aber wird nächste Woche definitiv nachgeholt. Ich hoffe, ihr findet den Grund dafür auch ausgesprochen gut. Ich hoffe, Derek May war interessant für euch. Und New York läuft uns ganz bestimmt nicht weg. Das war jetzt jedenfalls The Sound of Berlin am Anfang, Future Rhythm. Ihre neue auf Planet Records. Planet heute, wie gesagt, in Altstrahlau. Und das ist die andere Seite von Future Rhythm, Raw Love, auch Planet Records. Und dazwischen war Groove Sector auf High Bias und JAC, JLC. Eine Essential Beats and Breaks Platte aus Berlin und natürlich aus Miami. It came from outer base. It came from outer planet. Futurism, your love. Yeah.
Thank you.